गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन एंड गुड आफ्टरनून सॉरी एंड शुभ विजय ऑल ऑफ यू. सो टुडे मोमिता मैम इज एब्सेंट सो दैट्स व्हाई आई विल टेक दैट क्लास एंड आई विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द एवरीवन म्यूट योर माइक. I will start from the excretion in the animals, okay, because I have completed the transportation chapter, page number 126. I have completed the heart structure, circulation, the heartbeat, up to the heartbeat. Today we will continue from the excretion in animals, okay, page number 126. Okay. Okay. Thank you very much, everyone. Shubho Vijaya to all of you. So you know that our body also performs so many functions. Okay. So that's why syllabus for the science Hasibul, the Momita ma'am will tell you because she will continue her chapter and today just I will come and happy not half yearly term one and. Ma'am, will tell you what is your syllabus, okay? No need to worry about that. Very sort of hard type of question will come. That's maybe MCQ, that's maybe 1 marks question and 50 marks exams. So just read the chapters very carefully. And Momita ma'am asked to the e-portal to the Momita ma'am what is the syllabus of the class 7 term 1. She definitely tell you what is your syllabus. Recall how carbon dioxide is removed as waste from the body through the lungs through the exhalation. You know that our body also performs so many the cells, each and every cells perform their activities, and after the activities so many toxic material, undigested products also produce in our body, and this is not good for our health. So that's why we should get rid from this excretory materials or toxic materials, and we cannot get rid of them. That is automatically released from our body. There is some organs is present to continue this type of the excretory systems, okay? So excretory system is present to complete or to remove the toxic material from our body. Also recall that the undigested food is removed during the digestion. So when carbon dioxide that is produced in our body, but is by each and every cells, that is at the time of the breathing. You already read in your respiration chapter that is the carbon dioxide released at the time of the breathing, because carbon dioxide is not good for our health, that is good for the plants. So that's why they intake the carbon dioxide for their photosynthesis. The undigested food, the extra parts of the food, that is also released in the form of the tools from our body. So this is the different types of the process out in the form of the sweating, in the form of the tears. So many things, toxic materials are present in our body, is get released from our body. Let us now and find out how other waste materials are removed. Toxic means poisonous, that is harmful. How the other waste material are removed from the body. We may wonder where these unwanted materials come from, because not only we only intake food, so that's why the undigested material present. Yours each and cells, there is so many biochemical process also occurs in your body, digestion, excretion, and you can already read in the higher section so many things are happened in your body, glycolysis, fermentation, anything that is muscle cramps, you also know that lactic acid production. So this is also toxic for our body. So how they remove from your body? This is by the process of the excretion. When our cells perform their functions, certain waste products are released. These are from the body. The process of removal of the waste produced in the cell of the living organisms is called excretion. So what is the excretion? Excretion is just one type of the biological process. The biological process by which our living organisms remove the waste products from the cells is known as the excretion. So what is excretion? The biological process by which our the living organism, you can say that by which the cells of remaining or the cells of living organism cells of living organism remove waste product known as excretion. Okay, so you can say that one is the excretion, the biological process by which the cells of living organism remove the waste product from their body, that is known as the excretion. Okay, the parts involved in the excretion from the excretory system. So many organs, so many different type of the parts are present in our body which are actively involved in the excretory system. Excretory system in human. So how the excretory system is constitute, or which type of parts are present in the human excretory system, consist which part? Okay, two kidneys are present, two duct, that is called ureter or urinary tract, you can or duct, you can say that. Then urinary bladder, a pouch like structure where urine is stored, urinary bladder. Urethra, that is also some muscular structure which helps to release the urine, urethra. And urinary opening to release the urine. Okay, so these are the main parts of the excretory system: kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder, urethra, and urinary opening. So let's see what is their function. The waste which is present in the blood has to be removed from the body. Obviously, the waste material, toxic material, harmful material present in the blood, because our blood is the connective tissue and it is liquid. So many things that is dissolved in the blood that's may be harmful, that's may be useful. But the useful things are absorbed by our body and harmful things are released from our body as the form of the urine by the help of the kidney. Actually, kidneys work as a strainer in our body. Okay, to restrain the all harmful substances from the blood. A mechanism to filter the blood is required, obviously, to remove the toxic material from the blood. This is done by the blood capillaries in the kidneys. So kidneys, there is some blood capillaries, glomerulus. When you really read the in higher section, what is the structure, Tanisha, the ma'am will tell you what is your syllabus. So when blood reaches to the kidneys, it contains both useful and harmful substances. The useful substances are absorbed back to the in the water, the blood, and the waste dissolved in the water are removed as the urine. So urine, actually this is in the form of the liquid, and totally that is 95% of water is present. So as much as you can intake water, you can release the large amount of the toxic material from your body. So you should drink water each and every day in the large amount. In the summer time, you can do some activity, you can get tired, you can feel thirsty, so that's why you can intake water. But especially in the winter season, we cannot do so many activities, but if we do the activities, we cannot get tired as much as in the summer, so we cannot drink the water properly. But each in summer and winter, both time you should drink water for your proper functions of the body. As much as you water, drink the large amount of the urine released from your body, you can release the poisonous material from your body. Okay, everyone should drink water each and every day in the large amount, so your body function properly, you should stay healthy, everything, and your kidneys, all these things are also function properly. So from the kidneys, the urine goes into the urinary bladder. There is bare bladder-like structure through the tube-like ureters. There is some two track or tube are present, that is urinary tube, that is ureter is present. From the kidney to the urinary bladder, the ureter is present. It's stored in the bladder and is passed out through the urinary opening at the end of a muscular tube called urethra. There is some muscular pouch-like structure is muscular. Actually, urethra is the muscles. Actually, this relaxation and contraction helps to release the pressure is coming before the urination. This is due to the presence of the ureter. There is some sphincter muscles. Some muscles are present. No need to remind that. Muscles are present which contracts and relax and helps to release the urine from the urinary bladder through the urinary opening. Okay, the kidneys, ureters, bladder and urethra form the excretory system. So these are the different parts of the excretory system. In adult human being, normally passes about 1 to 1.8 liter of urine in the 24 years. So you don't know you how much water you drink, but you can release 1 to 1.8 liter urine from each and every day in the 24 hours. So how many water your body is needed to release the urine? You can imagine now. You should drink water 2 to 2.5 liters to 3 liters each and every day, because your body, if you continuously release the water in the form of the urine, in the form of the sweating, in the form of the tears, so how, from where your body get water? You will suffer from the dehydration. Your proper body functioning does not occur. So you should drink water in the large amount to proper functioning of your body parts. Okay. So what is the amount of the urine each and every adult human release in 24 hours? 1 to 1.8 liter urine, okay, in 24 hours. A adult human. This urine consists of 95% of water and 2.5% urea and 2.5% other ammonia anything. So only 5% toxic material and 95% water is released from your body in the form of the urine. We will all experience that we sweat on the hot summer day. The sweat contains water and salt. So not only sweating means that is water goes your body, some useful salts, minerals also release from your body. Okay. Bojo has said that sometimes in the summer white patches are formed on our clothes. In the summer time you can see that some white patches because the salt, you can see that the bag, you can intake your bag, this bag, the school bag also in the back side, that is also form some white patches because the salt that is released from your body, that is patchy dried in your bag. So in so you can see in the visibly that some salts are present. So you should clean that properly, your sweating, your clothes, your bag, your body also, because otherwise there is some bacteria, fungus also start to live there. Why our body have toxic in body? What is this question, Hasibul? The toxic materials mean poisonous material, harmful material, the unnecessary things that's present by the in the process of intaking of the food. Each and every parts of the cell, digestion, circulation, and after completing each functions, your body produce some toxic material. Respiration, carbon dioxide also produce. Some cells, they also form different types of the biochemical activities. When you upgraded into the higher classes, you can read that your body functions from glycolysis, lactic acid production, the muscle cramps, where the lactic acid goes after the releasing. So all these things are released from your body by the process of the urine. And now this process, different types of the process, circulation, digestion, respiration, anything, excretion also, so not all these things are released from your body by the excretion. Some parts are present in your body. So these things day by day released by our excretory systems, okay? What is formed in the bags, clothes during summer? Salty patches. The salt that is released by the sweat in your body, that is form the patch-like structure. Because they dried, that's why you can see them when they release it, that is mixes with the water. So water get evaporated, that is dried, but the soil remains on the bag, sweater, clothes. That's why you can visibly see them. you know how the salt is processed in your classic. You have known that how the salt is processed from this process, because the marine water that is evaporated and salt remained on the ground. Same things happened with your body. The salt is coming out with the sweat, sweat is evaporated, the salt is present on your bag, on your clothes. So that's why you can visibly see them. Sometimes if you rub them, they will go up. But this is should not do, because there is some bacteria, fungus is also present. So that's why we should clean your clothes each and every day, okay? Does sweat serve any other functions? The water kept in and the earthen pot of the cooler, because the water evaporates from the pores of the pot, which causes cooling. I have already told 10 times, I can't tell your syllabus because Momita ma'am is taking your class. If you have any question, you can ask your Momita ma'am in your reportal, and she will definitely next day tell your syllabus, because today she is absent. So does sweat, you know that in the every person has no capability to take the refrigerator in their homes. You can see their homes, they keep their water in the earthen pot that is made by the mud, because they are very fine pores are present, the small fine pores are present on the total pot's body. They are very fine, so that's why water not large amounts coming out, but they are evaporated in the small amount. So they keep cooling the earthen pot, so when you take the water, you can also feeling good. The way in which waste chemicals are removed from the body of the animals depends on the availability of the water. Aquatic animals, so toxic materials, poisonous material that is released in the form of the urine, that is in the form of the water. So that's why how many poisonous material, excretory material you release from your body totally depend on the water. So you should drink water in the large amount. Aquatic animals like fishes excrete shell waste ammonia, which is directly dissolved in the water. Some land animals, birds, lizards, snakes excrete semi-solid products, the major excretory products in the human, in the urea. Okay, so different animals according to their habitat, they have different excretory products. Okay, we can intake water large amounts. The availability of water is present, so that's why we can release our excretory products in the form of the urine, because this water you can replace. But the birds, the lizards, they can intake less amount of the water, so that's why their urine is the semi-solid form, not the liquid, not the hard form. Okay, that is known as the uric acid. And the fishes, there is ammonia is totally dissolved in the water, so they release their water excretory products in the form of the ammonia. So what is the excretory product of the aquatic animals? Ammonia. What is the excretory products of birds, lizards? Uric acid. What is the excretory products of the human? That is urine. Different animals have the different excretory products. Sometimes a person's kidneys may be stopped working due to the infection or injury. As a result of kidney failure, waste products start accumulating in the blood. Such persons cannot survive unless their blood is filtered periodically through the artificial kidney, the process of the dialysis. So dialysis, what is dialysis? Dialysis actually artificial process of the transplantation of the artificial kidney. Okay, so your body, if the kidney is failure, how your body release the excretory material from your body? If it is continuously accumulated in your body day by day, this should affect your other organs of your body. So you should release them from day by day. So this work is done by the artificial kidney, by the process of the dialysis. This is known as the dialysis, the artificial kidney transplant. Heart attack when occurs, heart is transplanted. This type of process, kidney also transplanted, that is known as the dialysis. Okay, so this is up to for the today. We'll continue my rest of the part in my next video, and Momita ma'am will take your next class. She will definitely tell you what is your syllabus. No need to worry about that. Just read your previous chapter and the new ones which the Momita ma'am telling, this is maybe your syllabus. Okay, and you know what is your syllabus. Okay, thank you everyone, bye everyone, stay safe.